Superglass, we're looking at liquids that turn into glass when we cool them down. And while they're cooling down, we're making a bunch of measurements of the properties of the liquid. How much it's flowing, how heavy it is, how dense it is, how much surface energy there is. And by measuring those things as we cool it down, we learn a lot about the nature of those liquids that form glasses. So that helps us develop new kinds of glass and helps us understand how to push glass in the direction we want to get the properties for optical materials or displays or lasers. So we're using an instrument called the electrostatic levitation furnace. So the experiment would involve melting the sample, getting it really hot. There are four laser beams that shine on it, and it gets very hot, very fast actually. You can get up to 2000 degrees centigrade, even 2500 degrees centigrade. The target application that we've typically looked at is optical materials. It's one of the premium applications for glasses. One of the exciting outcomes of the superglass experiment is that we've discovered a glass that has very efficient fluorescence behavior and is a very strong material. It's very hard, very strong, thermally stable. And that's a difficult combination to get. And that's just the kind of glass that's useful for applications because it improves reliability, allows you to run at higher power. So we're developing that material. It's an exciting direction that's come out of this work. There's lots of things you can do with glass, and of course it's formable, so you can make it into useful forms. You know, all the way from container glasses, vials for pharmaceuticals, for example, and even beer bottles, which are quite high-tech materials in many cases, up to what are often called functional glasses, the kinds of materials that are used on computer screens and particularly phone screens where they have multifunctions. In the case of fiber optics, they can be light guides, wave guides, transmit information and light over long distances. And then as a laser host, they're very convenient because you can dissolve laser active materials into a glass. There are some very high power lasers around these days that are made from glass.